Hello, Forecaster here again, and we are back for episode 6, and I'm stood here outside the Darkwaters General Store, and I basically repeated what I did up until this store from the last episode. I did kill some more bandits, and as a result, I leveled up, and apparently that's nothing out of the ordinary. And I gained a perk, which is, so, let's see. Awareness. Give you more detailed information about people. Bonus. Hand-to-hand damage. Earlier sequence. Okay. Night vision. Presence. Quick pockets. That might be nice. Smooth talker. Okay. And swift learner. This might be a good choice. Since we are fairly early, it will make gaining levels. I mean, it costs us these two first levels, in that we will not get one of these other perks right now, but it will improve our rate of leveling up overall for all the future levels by 5%, which is pretty good. However, I don't know. I suspect I have to pick one. I mean, if I click cancel, do I guess you can. I wouldn't be surprised if you can choose not to pick a perk at all. I don't know which one to get. This one is out because I don't really use hand to hand. Oh, it includes melee attacks as well. Then it might actually be a good choice. This one might be good as well, because it might help convincing people to do things. I'm not sure what this does. Initial reaction of another person. I don't know what that is for. This one would be nice as well, because it might let me shoot someone before they shoot me. This might also be nice, because you can get, it might let me know how much health someone has. I think I'm going to pick this, because I like being aware of things. So now we need double the experience to get to the next level. So we need just under 3,000 points now, which is fine. We have gained some health, so we now have almost 40 hit points instead of 30 something. So when I left this store, combat started when I was about down here, and I didn't know why, but these people started shooting, and I couldn't see inside the store, so I didn't know what was going on until I got to about here, when I could, and I could move the camera to get rid of the roof, and apparently this guy called Kenji had started attacking our Killian here, the shopkeeper, and the guards promptly killed him, and I didn't really have time to do anything. But I didn't need to. I did gain this nice hunting rifle, which uses the .223 caliber ammo that we, I think that's what this is. Yes. So now we have EUs for that, which is good. So I might end up using that for stuff. It does 8 to 20 damage, which is fairly good. Probably shouldn't have my weapon out when running around here in case people turn hostile. But anyway, let's have a chat with this gang that happened to murder me last time. Also, I had a chat with Killian, and he said that this gang, whatever they were called, apparently had a tendency to cause trouble for the town. So, I don't think people would mind if I got rid of them. Let's equip my last spear and see what kind of damage that does. 3 to 11, range is 2. That is better than the knife for sure. Let's see, the knife has a 1 to 7 damage, which is really crappy. And it has a range of 1, which means I have to stand next to whatever I want to shoot at. 10 to 16 or 8 to 20. This lower damage is a little better. And since we are in close quarters, I might want to use this one. I'm pretty sure I saved, but let's just do it again to be doubly sure, in case I forget. And then we're going to stab this woman with a spear. 4 hit points. But I get to attack twice. And of course the other people in the gang didn't like that very much, unsurprisingly. So I might have to stab them with spears as well. Dang it. You get to attack a lot in melee. Dang. I would like to kill this guy because I suspect he does a lot of damage. Do you have a switchblade? This might go worse than I thought it would, even though I'm prepared. And I have been thoroughly surrounded. Dang it. Come on. I am probably going to die because this guy does a lot of damage. Yeah. I'm going to die now. Right.
Not even the carry.
Let's try this again. And let's open up this door. And let's try one of these. Now I don't know how these work. Unfortunately, these people are a little spread out. Probably take out this guy. So that's one kill, and you should be pretty hurt. Uh-oh. Oh, so he has a gun. And I am surrounded again. Should probably take out this lady and try to retreat. Oh, I got knocked down. I might actually die again. I probably will before I'm able to get out. Right, so let's run away if I can. And I'm dead. I'm surrounded again. Great. Nope. I don't think that's going to work. I'm probably going to die. Let's try the hunting rifle. As you can see, I've equipped my... This is leather armor? Okay. Looks like metal to me, but what do I know? Let's equip some stim packs, or a stim pack. And let's be stood over here. And let's try shooting you. Oh wow. That was effective. And that's going to attract your attention. Which is not that surprising. But I think I have a better chance now than I did before. This seems like a much better plan to keep at range, especially since it appears most of them have melee weapons. I haven't one-shot one of them yet, though, which is a bummer. You're not going to be able to attack. We might have to go into retreat mode now and not attack. Maybe we can get some help from the guards that hang out by the convenience store or general store down here. Don't know why I keep saying convenience store. It seems the remaining gang members didn't notice or lost us or something. Come on, guards, please attack. Seems the guards don't really care. So, I guess I'm going to have to leave the area. The alternative is to stay and fight, but I guess I can take these on. Oh. Well, that's something. Hopefully this guy will go down as well. Nope. But he won't be able to kill me. Before I kill him. Hopefully. I mean, he doesn't have any weapons apparently, so... There we go. That went a lot better, so let's end combat there. And now it's looting time again. I miss the take all option. But oh well. We get some more money and some junk to turn into money. And apparently this guy had two knives for some reason. I don't know. Let's reload that gun. Now there should be... There she is. Wow, three caps. These armors are worth quite a lot. Let's get this stuff from here. And it looks like it's only him left, so... We're going to save here in case he hears me or something while I loot Cherry here. Only had a knife, it seems. And then we're going to step into here and shoot him. 13 hit points. Probably going to run around this corner here. And then we're going to run as far as we can in this direction. I think we better stand our ground to get some additional armor. Nice, 24 damage. I think I'm going to have to use this, otherwise he's going to kill me. And unfortunately he's going to get another turn. Hopefully he's a very good shot. I hope... no. I was hoping that I would kill him. Missed because of the additional range, and then we'll run. Oh, he's retreating. That will give us some time to use a stim pack. Can I? No, I can't shoot him from here. Very difficult to see where lines of sights are. Yes! Ha! Down he goes. 11 hit points left. Goody. Let's reload that and loot old Vinny, who had a 10mm. So leather and a leather jacket. There we go. So now this gang's been taken care of. I wonder if I can talk to someone and get some sort of reward for this. That would be nice. There's a fridge here. Maybe there will be some food in there. Before I forget, I'm going to save after this fight. Ooh. Wonder if I can take this or if the hotel keeper is going to object. Oh, I can't carry more stuff. Oh well. I'm going to have to find a... Can I sell stuff to you? I should be able to sell stuff to this person. Wonder how many caps she's got. None. She only has shotgun shells. That's not useful to me. Let's just leave. Let's go down to the store here again. He probably won't have more caps for me. Wait, what? Oh. I should probably put my weapon away when approaching the guards outside of a store. Might be a good idea. I suspect that's what caused them to attack me. Or not. Oh, yeah, I can see what they're... what weapon they're using. Why are you hostile? Is it because I killed these gang members? You said they were a problem. And they attacked me for talking with them. That's not fair. Who are you? Peasant. Okay. Well, that's annoying. I wonder if there's another area transition point up here. There might be. Or more buildings. Doesn't look like there's another area up here. There's one up here. This ought to lead to the casino area. And there's probably more guards there that will attack me as well. Yeah, here's the Gizmo's casino place. And presumably these guards will attack me as well. Yeah. Who are you? A gambler. What are you going to do? Seriously? Seriously. Wow. Okay, so the gamblers are hostile. But the guards aren't. What? Right. So, who are you? Roulette dealer? Gambler? Look like a zombie. Roulette dealer and a gambler? Okay. Hello. Tin wall. You a gambler? You're hostile, sort of, but you're running away? Okay. This is a weird, weird game. It was alright up to this point, but...
Get your butt in here and sit down. We got some business to discuss.
Okay...
Alright, here's the deal. Junktown, it ain't what it used to be. The only reason it's still here is because of my gambling establishment. Even so, Killian's been breathing down my neck. And I'm starting to take it personal. And that's where you come in, Slick.
And...
What I think is you're okay. Going to take him out for me, you know? No witnesses, just in, over, out.
Okay.
1,000 caps, no more, no less.
Oh.
Sorry you feel that way.
Okay.
Not as sorry as you're gonna be, though. Can't let a word of this get out.
Right. Ow. Stop that. Dang it. Kinda wish I had the shotgun right about now. Oh, he's going to shoot me as well. That's annoying. Probably going to die. And by probably, I mean definitely. Yeah. Right. So... because I saved after killing these people in here, I'm kind of stuck with this. Now... okay, you don't have anything to say about the massacre that just happened in here. Now, I suspect that the reason the guards are now hostile towards me is either, could be one of two reasons, or maybe both. One, they saw me shoot two of them, or be in combat with two of them when I pulled them down here in front of them and then killed them afterwards. Or it's because I attacked these people without them initiating combat first. So, it's assuming it is murder, which it kind of is, rather than self-defense. Now, unfortunately, this save is in the bandit camp, or raider camp, before my last bout with them. Is this from even before I attack them at all? Somehow I doubt it. Looks like it is. So there should be a couple of guys up here. Right? There's one. Yeah. Two. Yeah, so this is before I attack them at all, so I'm going to have to redo all that stuff. Pretty much clear out most of this raider camp, and then go back to Junktown and sell the loot again. And then we're going to have to try dealing with that gang again, let them initiate combat first, like last time, and then kill them all, and see if that puts me in a better eye with the guards. So that's going to be the plan. So between episodes, I'm going to have to redo all of this stuff. Not going to have you suffer through it at all, because it's going to be the same thing pretty much. So I will see you in Junktown in the next episode, before we deal with that gang. So I will see you then.